Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron, I hope you're having a great day in Jesus. We're going to look at how to win at spiritual warfare. We want you to win battles at spiritual warfare. So the few scriptures that we've got to kind of take as our baseline, because you know, like the Bible says in Ephesians 4:27, give no place to the devil. I mean, if you're giving place to the devil, he's going to win. So let's go to 1 Peter chapter 5. 1 Peter chapter 5. And we're going to start at verse number 8. And it says this. It's talking about Satan, our enemy. It says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil. I remember famous, was it Wiersbe wrote a famous book on overcoming the adversary. Your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. So Satan goes to and fro in the earth. Job chapter 1, Job chapter 2 tells us that. Verse 9 says, whom resist steadfast in the faith. Steadfast in the faith. So first of all, to win spiritual warfare, it's not holy water, it's not incantations, it's not any of these things. It's you've got to stand steadfast in the faith. The faith once delivered unto the saints. Now, who won the ultimate victory over Satan? Jesus. So we have to be in Jesus. If we're in Christ, we too can win the ultimate victory over the devil. Now, how do you get in Christ? 1 Corinthians 12:13. You can follow along if you'd like. 12:13 says, for by one Spirit are we all baptized into one body, whether we be Jews or Gentiles, whether we bond or free, and have been all made to drink into one Spirit, one plan of salvation for Jew and Gentile alike. It's a horrible hyper-dispensational and false doctrine out there that says there's two different plans of salvation, one for Jew, one for Greek. No, it's the same plan of salvation. You can see that all through the New Testament, to Jew and Greek alike. And so by one Spirit, we're all baptized into one body. How you get in the body of Christ is through being in the kingdom of God, Jesus Christ. The kingdom of God is within, being born of water and Spirit. So faith in Jesus Christ, in His blood, His shed blood, His atoning blood for you and I, the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, repentance, water baptism in Jesus' name for the remission of sins, receiving the gift of the Holy Spirit. If any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. There's many of you out there that are like Apollos, and you're like the 12 disciples of John in Acts 19, that you love the Lord, but you need to go just a little further and get real New Testament, Acts 2:38, plan of salvation. So that's really the very first thing in winning at spiritual warfare. Now let's look at some other ways to win at spiritual warfare. Verse 3 of 2 Corinthians chapter 10 tells us about the powerful weaponry God has equipped His church and His people with. It says, for though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. They're not fleshly. That's not your Glock. It's not your Smith & Wesson. But mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. So what we learn from this is that we have weapons, plural. Secondly, they're not carnal, but spiritual. Thirdly, they're mighty through God. And fourthly, they pull down strongholds. So what are some of these weapons? Well, of course, you know, in Ephesians chapter 6, we see the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. When Satan came to Jesus, the Word of God in flesh, Jesus started just quoting Old Testament scripture. I've known of people that didn't hardly know anything about the Bible, but when they would quote scripture, Satan could not get to them. And I will tell you, yes, Satan can quote scripture. Satan quoted Psalm 91. He did a bad job of it, but he quoted Psalm 91 to Jesus during his temptations. So the Word of God is really your ultimate weapon. Psalm 149 talks about the praises of God's people, binding kings and princes. It's talking about spiritual kings and princes, even though we have examples like 2 Chronicles 20 of praise and worship winning the battle against God's enemies. Who went forth first when they came out of Egypt to fight the battles? Judah, which Judah means praise. So the Word of God is a weapon. Praise is a weapon. prayer, of course, is a weapon. It says praying with the Spirit, groanings that can't be uttered. We've got infirmities we don't even know about. Prayer is this awesome weapon of our warfare. And I'll tell you, if you go out with those three weapons and a clean, pure, holy life, because again, give no place to the devil, you're on the winning side. You've got a winning combination. Satan has been defeated through the power of the Holy Ghost, through the blood of Jesus Christ. And so you can win the weapons with the weapons that God has equipped you with. Verse number 5, casting down imaginations. Now, notice the last two words of verse 4 of 2 Corinthians 10 is strongholds. And then casting down imaginations. So what is a stronghold? A stronghold is a lying imagination that gives Satan place. Satan is a liar. He's the father of it. John 8:41-44. He's a murderer from the beginning. And so that thief, he's a thief, he's a robber, he's a father of lies, he's a deceiver. And it sets up a stronghold. So when we pray, when we use the word of God, when we pray, when we worship, strongholds fall down and victory is won. And so strongholds, there's masses of people that can believe strongholds. You know, if you go back to like 1 Kings 22, there was a lying spirit, scripture says, one lying spirit, you can read it for yourself, that deceived 400 prophets. He said, I'll be a lying spirit in the mouth of all these prophets of Baal. And so that's what happens is when people think incorrectly, they're not thinking the truth, then Satan sets up strongholds in those lies. And that's the reason you see certain areas, there are certain pockets, even denominations and things, and false religions. Not saying every denomination is necessarily false religion, but I'm talking about all kinds of things, that there are certain pockets because people begin to think the wrong things and Satan sets up strongholds there. So, overcoming the devil, winning spiritual warfare. Sometimes it's difficult. Sometimes it takes some time. Another fascinating passage on that is found in the book of Daniel. That great man Daniel, considered just an incredible guy in the in scripture. And he put it like this in Daniel, the 9th chapter, 10th chapter. What had happened is he had been fasting and an angel came to him and he said this. He said, well, let's just read it. I will read it in Daniel 10 and 12. Then said he unto me, fear not, Daniel, for from the first day that thou didst set thine heart to understand and to chasten thyself before thy God, that 21-day fast of no pleasant meat, people call it a Daniel fast, and to chasten thyself before thy God, thy words were heard, and I am come from thy words. So the second Daniel prayed, the first day, the prayer got to the throne of God. God says, you go help Daniel, angel. So the angel comes. But verse 13, but the prince of the kingdom of Persia withstood me 1 and 20 days. But lo, Michael, one of the chief princes, came to me, and I remained there with the kings of Persia. And I remained there with the kings of Persia. Now I am come to make thee understand what shall befall thy people in the latter days, for yet the vision is for many days. So God sends it. The first day Daniel prayed, God heard it, and the angel comes to deliver. But a prince of Persia, this was not a prince there on the throne of an earthly kingdom. This is a spiritual prince of Persia, blocked him from coming. And so that angel couldn't even get through for 21 days. Michael, one of the chief princes, had to come and block this prince of Persia so this angel could get through. So spiritual warfare in the heavenlies, it's incumbent upon the people of God to pray. We have not because we ask not. And so if you're not happy with the way things are in Washington, D.C., pray it out in Jesus' name. Look, President Trump, he talks about draining the swamp. A lot of people think he may be the swamp. We won't even go into any of that. But friend, the Holy Ghost, righteousness, exalteth a nation. Sin is a reproach to any people. You start fasting, you start praying, kingdoms come down. You don't like, you say, well, I think the media gives incorrect information and it's not vetted properly. And many times it may have an agenda and being seen through bias. I'm going to tell you, pray. You have not because you ask not. And so God wants righteousness to prevail. So how to win spiritual warfare? First of all, you got to be in Christ, because Christ is one, born again of water and spirit, and then utilize. It's not just enough to be in Christ. That's awesome. When I say it's not enough, I mean it's obvious enough for your salvation. But if you're going to go and do what God wants you to do and win these victories, you got to use the Word of God. You've got to pray. You've got to worship. You've got to be obedient, walk in holiness, and God will do mighty things in your life. Don't give any place to the devil. God is holy. You're living in that victory Jesus has won for us. Talk with you later. God bless you in Jesus' name.